Hello everybody, today we are going to make a cake. We are going to use 6 balloons of different colors to make this particular cake. Inflate all balloons leaving about 4-inch flat tails. Let's twist the first about 1-inch long white bubble. Now we have to attach all other balloons to the free end of the first white bubble. For this sculpture we are going to work all balloons in exactly the same way. You can use the same technique described in this instruction to make very different size sculptures, different shapes. So far we have attached 2 balloons together. Now we are attaching the third blue balloon. As you can see, I simply tie nozzle of one balloon to the free end of the first white bubble. We are going to twist all balloons to make exactly the same number of bubbles on each balloon. Well, except the first white bubble. The first white bubble I use as an additional bubble. It makes it easier to connect all balloons together, and also it hides the connection point. Also, I want to say that this cake is going to have 0 calories, 0 protein, 0 cholesterol, and it is not eatable at all. We're making this cake only for decoration purpose. Okay, we have attached all 6 balloons together. Let's cook. Twist the first about 5-inch long white bubble. Twist the second soft about 1-inch long white bubble. Lock both ends of the second white bubble in one lock twist. Now we have to work all other balloons in exactly the same way. Twist the first blue about 5-inch long bubble. Twist the second soft blue about 1-inch long bubble. Lock both ends of the second blue bubble in one lock twist. Now we have to twist the first red about 5-inch long bubble. Twist the second red soft about 1-inch long bubble. Lock both ends of the second red bubble in one lock twist. Then we twist the first pink about 5-inch long bubble. Twist the second soft pink about 1-inch long bubble. Lock both ends of the second pink bubble in one lock twist. There are 2 more balloons. Let's do now green balloon. And finally we work the yellow balloon same way. So far we are making the top layer of our cake. Now we're going to make connection bubbles. Let's make the third white about 5-inch long bubble. Let's lock the free end of the third white bubble with the second blue bubble. Then we have to twist the third blue about 5-inch long bubble. Lock the free end of the third blue bubble with the second red bubble. Then we twist the third red about 5-inch long bubble. And we lock the free end of the third red bubble with the second green bubble. The colors I choose randomly. You can use different colors or just one color if you want to make the sculpture. Twist the third green about 5-inch long bubble, lock it with the second yellow bubble. In this way we work around the sculpture to connect all balloons together. Here I'm making the third about 5-inch long pink bubble. Lock the free end of the third pink bubble with the second white bubble. We have made the top layer of our cake. We have made it out of 6 triangles. It is a top view and here's a side view. Let's make the second layer. Again I will start with a white balloon. Twist the fourth white about 1-inch long bubble. Twist the fifth soft white 1-inch long bubble. Lock both ends of the fifth white bubble in one lock twist. We work the rest of the balloons in the same way. Twist the fourth blue about 1-inch long bubble. Twist the fifth soft blue about 1-inch long bubble. Lock both ends of the fifth blue bubble in one lock twist. Then I twist fourth red 1-inch long bubble. Twist the fifth soft red 1-inch long bubble. Lock both ends of the fifth red bubble in one lock twist. As I mentioned before, we can use this technique to make different sculptures. In this example we work with 6 balloons. We can use this technique to work with 2 balloons, 3, 4, any number of balloons. Also, we can make different size bubbles to make different shapes. I will refer to this technique many more times in future instructions when we will make different sculptures. Alright, back to our sculpture. We worked all six balloons in the same way. Now let's twist the six white about 5-inch long bubble. Lock free end of the six white bubble with the fifth blue bubble. Twist the six blue about 5-inch long bubble. Lock the free end of the six blue bubble with the fifth red bubble. Then we twist the six red about 5-inch long bubble. Lock the free end of the six red bubble with the fifth green bubble. Then we twist the six green bubble about 5-inch long. In all instructions I give very approximate size of all bubbles, adjusted to your needs. Here I lock the six green bubble with the fifth yellow bubble. Make the six yellow 5-inch long bubble, lock it with the fifth pink bubble. And finally we're making the six pink bubble about 5-inch long and lock the free end of the six pink bubble with the fifth white bubble. Fix all bubbles in proper positions. We have made the second layer of our cake. Here's a side view. Basically we have made the cake. If you want, you can stop and cut off the rest of the balloons, tie off the ends. Or you can use the same balloons to make a couple more layers if you want. From the side you can see clearly the color pattern we were working, like a steps or Z-shaped. I want to use this sculpture as a head, so let's make one more layer. We are going to work the third layer in exactly the same way as we did the second layer. In this example I'm going to connect all balloons in exactly the same direction. We can make a different color pattern by changing direction in which we connect balloons of each layer. And there are many different color patterns we can make working in this way, weaving balloons in different directions. Making different color patterns is very interesting, and you should explore this topic on your own. Most certainly I will show you many different weaving techniques and different color patterns in future instructions. I personally like color patterns that create optical illusions. Okay, now back to our sculpture. Here we have made the 7th and the 8th bubbles on each balloon. And now we have to make the connection bubbles. Here's a top view. It always remains the same. Let's twist the 9th about 5-inch long white bubble. Lock the free end of the 9th white bubble with the 8th blue bubble. This way we connect bubbles of the 3rd layer working in the same direction as we did the 2nd and the 1st layer. Lock the free end of the 9th blue bubble with the 8th red bubble. Twist the 9th red bubble. Lock the free end of the red 9th bubble with the 8th green bubble. Twist the 9th 5-inch long green bubble. Lock the free end of the 9th green bubble with the 8th yellow bubble. Twist the 9th yellow about 5-inch long bubble. Lock the free end of the 9th yellow bubble with the 8th pink bubble. Twist the 9th pink about 5-inch long bubble. Lock the free end of the 9th pink bubble with the 8th white bubble. Alright, we have made the third layer of our cake. Let's fix all bubbles in proper positions. Here's a top view. Again, you can make a larger size sculpture. You can add more balloons to it if you need. You can use the rest of the balloons to make some decorations for the cake. You can pull the ends of the balloons inside of the cake and then through the top. Bend the balloon on the top and force it inside of the cake. This way you can make decoration. I'm not going to do it now. I want to use this sculpture as a head. So I'm going to simply cut off the rest of the balloons. You can do it with scissors. Or you can just tear off the ends of the balloons with your hands. tie off the ends and hide them between bubbles of the sculpture. You can use the rest of the balloons to make decorations for the cake as flowers or balloon candles. You can always visit my website feudoit.com to look for more ideas and instructions how to make different sculptures and decorations for the sculptures. The ends of the balloons you can trim nicely with scissors, or again you can just simply hide it between bubbles of the sculpture, is what I do here. Alright, congratulations again. We have made a cake, 3 layers cake. Here's a side view. Flip this cake upside down and you'll get basket or vase. Using this technique we can make umbrella, furniture. Here's a bottom view. You can make bodies, houses, and so on and so on. And again, we can use this sculpture as a hat. In this example I made the hat a bit larger size than it has to be. Well, let it be. Have fun and happy twisting!